In 1930, Cadillac stunned the automotive world by introducing a V16 engine that pushed the standards of automotive engineering and increased the maker's reputation as the standard of the world. In 2008, the Danbury Mint has done much the same in miniature by introducing a staggering 1/12 scale model of a Cadillac V16 Roadster, so full of magic and operating features that it's an impossible image to ignore. Hi, I'm Joe Kelly Jr. Tonight on Playing with Cars, we're going to do anything but ignore that model as we examine it from bumper to bumper. Get your goggles on. This one gets pretty deep. Cadillac had owned the Fleetwood Metal bodywork since the 20s, but it wasn't until 1930 that the relationship became completely monogamous. The timing would prove to be perfect, because a talented young fellow named Harley Earl would be there just in time to wrap Caddy's new V16 in some of the era's most prestigious and beautiful bodywork. Among the most striking of these catalog customs was the one penned for the V16 Roadster, a dashing machine that rode a 148-inch wheelbase and shared much of its mechanicals with the lesser 353 series V8 caddies. Forward of the cowl, however, things were distinctly different. With a displacement of 452 cubic inches, the narrow-angled V16 was engineered to impress. If the smooth performance of those 16 cylinders didn't wow the neighbors, the car's close to $7,000 asking price, a number close to the middle of the Caddy range in 1930, surely did. So where do you start with a model like this? Well, if you're one of the ones who have it on order, I'd suggest you start with the instruction sheet. Though it's a remarkably durable and well-engineered piece, a wrong move could spell disaster, not to mention something very much like a broken heart. As the latest model to join Danbury Mint's much-celebrated 1/12 lineup, this Cadillac has massive presence right out of the box. True, something this size would catch the eye regardless, but the finesse at work here is remarkable. Once taken from its protective shell and placed on the table, all it takes is a few moments to attach the hubcaps, add the lock-on radiator ornament, and begin to enjoy the old Cadillac's flawless paint and polish. Real metal bumpers, hand-laced wire wheels, stainless steel louvers, and body hardware and trim pieces are installed on the car with unerring precision. I counted zero build flaws, and the finish on the car is absolutely unimpeachable from front to back. The finely ground metallic that floats in the model's paint is so evenly applied and lavishly polished that it sparkles in scale. Not an easy or inexpensive effect to achieve. Added to that is the exceptionally well-done pinstriping that darts all around the car's trim, a detail that was almost impossible to spot in photos, but one that adds an edge to the model's unforgettable visual. Had this maker stopped at the point of a curbside model, the model would have been magnificent. But Danbury took the image further, much further. The hood, the doors, and the rumble seat all open and shut on whip-thin shut lines. Now these handles don't work, but the doors snick tight on neat little spring and ball catches, with the added attraction here being the posable wipers, the movable wind wings, and the tilt-out, fold-down windshield. True to the original, the Caddy steering wheel works the front wheels, as well as the set of geared-in driving lights out front. There are neat woven retaining straps keeping the doors in check, as well as realistic, albeit static, shift gear and handbrake assemblies. In front of the sliding bench seat, the cabin is dominated by the metal-intensive dash and the readable set of gauges, as well as switchgear and knobs that look real, because they are real. It's true, in the midst of all this scale finery, Danbury Mint has managed to include sophisticated electronics and illumination. No mean feat, because they've managed to do so without impacting the scale finesse of the model in the least. In addition to the working headlights, pilot rate driving lights, and the lighted gauges, the car's got honest-to-gosh working courtesy lights that add glow to the under-dash area and the running boards when the doors are open. How's that for slick? But that's not the limit, not by a long shot. Tweaking the Spark Advance lever on the steering wheel kicks in the high beams. And should you find the metal tool that comes with the model in your hand, and should you then decide to use it to press down the brake pedal, you'll notice that the brake lights get brighter out back. Now that's cool. Up front, no detail has been left untouched, starting with these real stainless steel hood louvers, each individually sprung and hinged and set into the stamped metal hood with its own latch assembly. Someone went nuts here, and that's before you even open the thing. Now once you do, you'll see the fruits of both the Cadillac engineers and the talents of the Danbury Mint. You see, one of the goals of the V16's designers was to make the engine as clean and uncluttered as possible, with hidden ignition wiring and beautifully sculpted and finished surfaces. The 185-horsepower engine's enameled slick quality is replicated to the nines under the car's butterfly hood, with well-prepped and painted castings set into place with great precision. The devil's in the details here, and this faux beading on the radiator and cowl, steel cables running to and fro, a slick little fuel bowl actually cast to look like it's filled with fuel, and every possible added static detail built in or onto the block. Even better, there's a rotating fan, triggered by the rear wheels and drive shaft. Nice touch, and smoothly done to boot. Speaking of boot, hey, I'm a Segway kind of guy, the model's fabric top cover is removable, all the better to get to the Caddy's working, convertible top. Now don't fear the learning curve on this one. The feature works so smoothly and reliably that it becomes second nature after only a couple of tries. The best part is the gorgeous finish on the pieces themselves, from the wood grain effect on the bows to the accurate weave of the fabric top. This is killer stuff. Out back, the car's got even more to give in the form of an opening side door. Just a thing for the duffer who kept his clubs at hand. And true to form, Danbury's put a set of clubs in here, wrapped in a sweet fabric golf bag. Pop the rumble seat open by pressing down on the rearmost edge and getting a finger in there, and you'll see the carpeted floor and walls and the working footrest. The luggage rack tilts and flattens out easily, and if you look a bit further up, you'll see a working battery box cover. Twisting the latch and opening the door reveals the battery tucked under the floorboards. On the other side, the model's got a complete set of tools stashed behind a similar door in this covered toolbox. Hey, there's a jack, too! It isn't a working jack, not really, but it does a great job keeping the Caddy up in the air while you change the tire. That's a pretty easy task to perform thanks to magnetically located hubcaps and a single securing lug nut with a special tool. The pieces are so well crafted and the results so cool to see that I'd recommend displaying the model at least part of the time with the wheel pulled and the rest of the tools in view. From the tiny crankcase vent tubes to the working drive shaft and the steel brake rods, the model's chassis is a note-for-note replication of the V16's tremendously strong and just plain tremendous frame. The attention lavished under here is a testimonial to this maker's art, and the final note in a symphony of detail and finesse that draws the viewer in for an ever closer look and never disappoints. Thank you. viewers say when they're faced with a model like this Cadillac? It was a staggering effort to bring this car out, from its design to the quality of its build. I've had many hundreds of models in my hands over the years, but few, if any, have reached out to me the way that this one does. Now, my hope for this car, once it's gone from here and on its way back to the Danbury Mint, is that it's going to be followed by another and another. Packards, Duesenbergs, American icons that will at last get the treatment that they deserve. Now, if you buy just one high-end model this year or ever again, my recommendation is that you give this one very serious consideration. Well, that's it for this episode of Playing with Cars. I want to thank the Danbury Mint for sending this Cadillac along for review. And I also want to thank all of you for your suggestions and your emails over the past couple of weeks. We're going to do our best to get those models that you've requested onto the show. So until that time, my name is Joe Kelly Jr. Thanks for coming down to the car room, and thank you for playing with cars. Take care. Bye-bye.